Hello friends, welcome back. In the previous lecture, we have discussed about the how to find effective stress if the flow is happening in the upward direction. So here we will discuss the how to find effective stress if the flow is happening in the downward direction. Flow in the downward direction. Similarly, let us consider a soil sample and let us consider that the length of the soil sample is Z. And imagine at the top of the soil, my water table up to like this. And let us say that the height of the water table I am maintaining here is nothing but a HW. And similarly, at the bottom of the soil, I am just imagining that I am keeping a span, and I am maintaining a level about, let us say, if this is my tail water level, okay, my difference between the water levels, let us say, my head difference between the water level is, let us say, small h, okay. Now, let us say, all these are soil particles, okay. Now, let us see what is the head available at point A and also what is the head available at point B. As we can see that, let us consider that your tail water level is here. Okay, now, what will be my head available at point A? That will be nothing but a datum head plus pressure head. So let us see what is the elevation head. The point A is above the reference axis or below the reference axis? Above the reference axis with almost distance Z. So what will be the datum head or elevation head plus Z? Similarly, if I keep my piezometer at point A, so up to what my water level will rise in the piezometer? It will rise up to a height of water table. What is the height of the water table above the point A? That is nothing but HW. So what will be the pressure head? That is nothing but plus HW. Similarly, let us find out what is the total head available at point B. Point B and the reference axis both are at the same level. And if I keep my piezometer here, my water table will rise up to which point? Isn't it? The water table and also the reference axis and also the point is at the same point. That means what is the head available at that point? Zero. That implies we can say that the head available at point A is greater than the head available at point B. That means how the flow will happen? The flow will happen from A to B. Right? So if the flow is happening in which direction? The flow is happening in the downward direction. So what will be the head loss if flow is happening from A to B? That is nothing but a head loss. HF I am representing with head loss available at point A minus head loss available at point B. If I subtract these two, how much I will get? I will get it as a HW plus Z. So this is nothing but a my head loss available if flow is happening from A to B. Now, the point is what will be the effective stress at the bottom of the soil sample? Similarly, how we will find out? Suppose if I want to find out the effective stress at point B, first what I have to find out? I have to find the total stress. So first of all, tell me, what is the total stress available at point B? If you keep your hand at point B, how much weight you will feel? You will feel the saturated weight of the sample and also you will feel the weight of the water above the A. So what will be the total weight? We can say gamma saturation into Z plus gamma W into HW. Similarly, what will be your pore water pressure at point B? If I keep my piezometer at point B, will there be any rise in the water table? How much the water table will rise? That is nothing but a, there is a small difference between these two. That implies we can say that tot out of the H minus Z plus HW. That means my pore water pressure, that will be nothing but a gamma W into HW plus Z minus H. So that implies we can say your pore water pressure will be this much. That implies what will be your effective stress? That is nothing but a gamma dash into Z plus gamma W into H. So this is how we will find out the effective stress at a point if the flow is happening in the downward direction. Okay, in the next lecture we will discuss about the how to find the seepage pressure, and also we will see how to find the seepage force. Okay, thank you.